We do not wait for a day in time to be grateful. We are forever grateful. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen on that.
Yes.
It's very important we, as the images and likeness of God, people who have known their true identity, recognize that love is all about gratitude. True love is really all about gratitude, being grateful all the time, regardless of what's happening around us. Bishop Patrick Kidwell will remind us that all things are working together for our good.
According to God's plan.
We are all called for this divine purpose. For we recognize truly all things, the bad, the good, whatever people call bad. So we give thanks every day. And so we know because it's working for our good, we can smile, we can be joyful. That's
yes.
does not mean that we are not humble and prayerful for others. Our gratitude does not stick to ourselves. We are grateful for one another. And so today we're going to open up our platform for as many persons who come to give thanks. And those of you who are really partnered as images and likeness of God, husbands and wives, we want a specific emphasis on your spouse. Why are you grateful? Why should someone be excited to be part of ACIM, Heavenly Couples? And so we want all of us who have our partners with us to please prayerfully make the emphasis on being grateful for the man or the woman of God that has completed the image and likeness of God in your life. And then others as single, blessed brothers and sisters, feel free to thank God for your parents, for your brothers and sisters, and for whatever is impressed on your heart. So we're going to begin. As we welcome others, we will get official greetings from all our co-conveners. I will identify them, our co-conveners, Bishop Rolay, no doubt, the Rolays, the Allens, and the Grays, who are currently online, will bring us Thanksgiving greetings in that order. Before we begin, we have a song we want to play to set us in the right frame of mind of gratitude. After that song, I would ask that my great sister, Bishop Patra Rolay, she is truly a praying woman, would open us up in prayer. And through opening us up in prayer, she would also, after her prayer, she would bring us a convener greetings and gratitude with her husband. I believe I just saw Max Rolay on the line.
Yeah, I'm trying to get him.
He's
there.
On the line. I just saw him on the line.
Okay, now. Good.
And after she does that,
honey, we can see you.
Yes, we can see your face yet. He's adjusting. I know he's out of town doing some great work.
No, he actually.
Okay.
It's in.
Anyway, when
you
the time is.
You got a problem with the speakers?
Maybe he will unmute himself. He has not unmuted yet. So after that, let's just go down this quickly. After the relays bring us prayer and convener greatings and gratitude, I will go to Dr. Gray. Dr. Gray would also do the same. Dr. Gray will bring us convener greetings and gratitude prayerfully. If Kim is around together, they would do that. And then we would go to one of our great founding conveners, the Allens. Dr. Bishop Tyrone Allen would then also come follow Dr. Gray and bring us convener greetings and gratitude blessings as God sees fit to lead you, brothers and sisters. So without further delay, as we welcome everyone, welcome Sister Elder Juliet Potter. Can you hear us? Welcome, Mrs. Bayo. You're on a different seat today, just like Max Rolay and Patra, but we are all one.
Yes, we are all one.
Regardless of where we are all one. So let's get this day, this beautiful day rolling, as day God has given to us, a day we shall rejoice and be glad in it. I want you to be grateful, and I know a lot of you are so grateful. Thank you. grateful. Today, gratitude is flowing from your heart.
This time, I want y'all to help us do it. Lift your hands in this atmosphere and say, I am grateful.
I am grateful for the things
that you have done.
Have done.
Look at them and tell them,
yes,
I'm grateful.
I'm grateful for the victories that we've won.
Tell them I could go on and on. And say, flowing from my heart,
take it over. Gratefulness flowing from
Hallelujah.
Our hearts.
We are so grateful at the Heavenly Couples. We decree that this is the day that our God has made. So we believe it is good. It's a perfect day. We have opportunities today. We have wonderful surprises and supernatural breakthroughs and miracles. We thank you, Father, because only you can make us to flourish, because only you have created us. Your word says in Psalm 92, and then I'm going to read from that God has already prepared us for such a time as this, as he continues to enlightening us and begin to, he is the Most High, for low enemies shall perish. That's why we are able to have thanksgiving. That's why we are able to give God praise. And he said that we are now anointed with fresh oil, and our eyes shall see the desire and see the desire of the enemies that shall rise up against us. So, Father, those that are planted in your house, the house of the Lord, the heavenly couples, we shall flourish and we shall triumph in the courts of our God. They, the heavenly couples, shall still bring forth fruit in old age, and they shall be fat and flourish. And so today we declare that our times are in your hands. Therefore, we are released from demonic circles, demonic seasons, calendars, and timetables. We are in sync and we're in season and in sequence as we continue to activate good times and blessed moments throughout the world and destroy the spirit which controls bad times, hard times, and struggling times. As heavenly couples, Father, we are saying that our times are in your hands, because we have so many other people that we need to develop with this information so that we can be family, that we return to your God, to the garden of peace. Therefore, Father, we decree and declare that this year and the years to come shall be filled with mind-blowing supernatural occurrences that will bring us great joy.
Hallelujah.
And we thank you for this day, this very time, that's this very season of Thanksgiving, because you are now telling us that we have dislodged ourselves from poverty. That's why we can give you praise. We have dislodged ourselves from hard times, hardship, from lack, from struggle, from chronic disease, and from sickness. We destroy those anchors now by the blood, by the power of the Holy Spirit. We thank you, Father, that you will begin to acquaint us with our heritage, who we are and where we come from, so we can continue to have our identity back in you. Thank you for prospering the works of our hands, and that you are unconditionally loving us, and that you are our God, and that we are getting to know you in your fullness, which is of great interest to you and to us. We want to know you, Father. So everything that has been owed to us, begin to release it now. Everything that has been seized from us, begin to release it now by the power, the blood, and the name of Jesus. Let the blessings that you are going to bestow on us as family, as the family of heavenly couples, let it be numerous, just like the stars, uncountable. Let it rain upon us, Spirit of God. Let our struggle be a distant memory as we continue to subdue our enemies. I pray for all the families online. I pray for those who are not able to join, you know, their spouses, who are not able to be here. We thank you, Father, that they will continue to be fruitful in all your endeavors. And God, you are granting us even multiple streams of income, because we have work to do even internationally. Lord. It is only by your word, by your power, that we are able to do this. Therefore, we call abundant wealth
abundant,
to be transferred into our hands. We call abundant wealth to be transferred into our hands. Thank you, Father God, that that's going to happen, and it's going to happen quickly too. Blessings come upon us and overtake us, and we succeed in whatever that we are doing, and our success will so much confront our critics, they will begin to get overwhelmed, because you are going to bless our ministries in various ways and bring us together as heavenly couples. We love you, God.
Love
this
you.
Is a day that the Lord has made, and so we pause to say thank you.
Thank
we pause
you.
To say we love you. Thank you, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We pause to say, yes, Lord, hallelujah. Only your will be done as everything come together according to God's will. Thank you again for all the families and all the couples. In Jesus' name, amen and adieu.
Amen and adieu. Amen, amen. Thank you, Bishop Rolley. Thank you. I wonder if Max Rolley, can you hear us, Brother Max?
Can you hear? Okay, go.
He said he can?
Yeah, he said he can. You want to say something?
Yeah, I had to get to the unmute.
Bless okay. you. Welcome. It's quite a little distance to the unmute, but it's good to hear you. Your wife, your wonderful partner just prayed. What are you grateful for about that? This great sister of mine and this great daughter of heaven, this great woman who makes you shine every day. Talk to us.
Well, you know, I'm not going to go with the stereotypical stuff because you all know her well. But this woman embodies the vows of marriage. In sickness and in health, I'll use an example. When I had some health issues, she was my nurse, not just my wife. She would make sure I was hydrated. She would make sure I eat. You know, she was the caregiver when I was down. Through good and bad is another vow that I got to tell you, this woman embodies throughout her life. When we went some tough times a couple of years ago, man, she was the solid rock on whom I stood. She is just the most phenomenal partner that God could have ever given to me.
My God.
Now he want me to cry. Don't listen to him.
Who can follow that? Bishop, let's thank God. Give thanks. Let's celebrate our sister. Yes. And the couple of the Rolais. I'm sure, Bishop Patra, you can do better than what he just did.
I can't, I tell you.
Oh, don't challenge her. Don't challenge her.
Oh, my God. Yeah. I'm so grateful. I'm just so grateful for knowledge. Because with knowledge, you know, you are getting to know God in his fullness. And so that's just my prayer. Sometimes in the morning, I just say, God, I want to know more of you today again. So, and I always get answers. I always get answers. There's a reason why God gave you your partner. He didn't just give you, because the false father wants us to think that you have a partner because, you know, but God gave you a partner is different from the false father pushed somebody to you. So if you begin to think in that route, you will begin to know that you are treating yourself. So if you know how to treat yourself bad, then you will treat your other half bad. So I treat myself so good, it has to extend to my spouse. Because I understand the knowledge of God. God is making us family. He wants his family back, and not in the systematic way. Because the systematic way have taught us wrongly. And so if we can get to God's own kind of love, the true love, then we will just, that will just be the life we live in. That's us. We're not learning how to be kind. No. We're not learning how to be patient. That's just us. That's what we do.
Oh, my goodness.
I'm grateful for my parents. I have parents, and my mother is 89. My father is 105. Woo! My father is 105. So I come from that lineage, and I'm very disciplined, and I'm grateful for being a parent, for being a wife to a wonderful man. One who cares, you know, who he's there. When he's talking about when he was down, I'm talking about when I was down. He picked me up like a paper, like it didn't even matter, you know. Oh my God. So what is God saying? We have to think about what God is saying, not what you did. What is God saying? Because if you picked me up like I was down, you just picked me up like a paper, that means you have been prepared to do that. So when you go down, what have I been prepared to bring you right back up? So because we are always going to be family. So I thank God for being a wife, for being a parent, and for being a mother, and for being mother to a lot of people, a lot of children, a lot of people, a lot of visions. I thank God for that. So basically, I'm thanking God for our heavenly parents.
Hallelujah. My beloved, if we allow each one of us, we will write a book that the world cannot.
Yes.
It will not, the books would of gratitude will fill everywhere. Thank you for sharing the Rolais. Let's show love to the Rolais. Thank you. Thank you. A brother with a fatherly heart and a sister with a motherly heart as son of God and as daughter of God. Thank you to the Rolais. Let's now move to another brother with truly a fatherly heart, truly. My great brother, Dr. Sinclair Gray. What are you grateful for? Bring us convener greetings about ACIM and share why you love Kim so much.
Oh my gosh.
Well, first of all, good morning, everybody. I'm hoping everybody's having a wonderful, wonderful Saturday. I bring you greetings from the Heavenly Couples Ministry. I can't see the face, but I'm so happy that Elder Julia Porter is on the call. Someone who has shared immense wisdom with me about the Native American history. Thank you so much. It's going so good. Thank you so much for the prayer. Wow. To describe Kim is hard to describe because she knows how much I love her. I am truly, truly thankful for her support, for her patience, for her understanding, and for her just being a rock. Someone who I can talk to, someone who I can confide in, someone who pushes me, someone who always wants the best for me. So, yes, I can write a book on her. I can write a book about her. And I, you know, she's occupied at the moment, but I'm always telling her she's my perfect angel. And I say that, you know, we're all not perfect, but she's my perfect angel. And that to me, she can do no wrong. With her love and her support, her kindness. So always pushing for better, always pushing me to be better, which makes me want to get better even more. So yes. That's what I have to say in that moment. I don't know if you heard me or not. She's probably busy at the moment. So
amen to that.
Amen.
Okay, no, so she didn't hear a word I said, so she's busy right now. So I'll tell her later.
No, this is being recorded, just so that you know. I always tell you
okay,
that.
Okay, no
that
problem. It's recorded, so I'll
so
share
it
with
she
her.
Will get it. And before she before this finish, we want to see her face. She's not too Amen. Busy to say something about you. So yes. We are grateful.
Hold on, let me see if I can grab her.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I know. That's what we do now.
Yes. This is the Heavenly Couples.
God gave us so much space, we can spread.
All right, yes. Hold on. No. Come on. I have my phone, so I'm gonna put her right here. I'm gonna put her on speaker. Hold on.
Amen.
Oh Lord.
Okay. Yeah,
good morning.
Good morning, Sister Kim.
Amen.
Good morning. How's everybody?
Very good.
Good. Oh, say something.
We just heard your husband describe an angel. And we want not just an ordinary angel, but a perfect angel, as Mrs. Bio re-echoed. So we want to hear, how did he deserve a perfect angel like you? What are you thankful for this great man who has received an angel?
Likewise for him. He is one of the kindest people I've ever known. So I'm lucky and blessed to have him in my life. He's very generous. He's supportive. And I used to describe him, but it's still to his best friend before we got married. I said, he's just precious. And he really is precious. So that's what I have to say about him. He's a true man of God. He's prayerful. He's like I said, supportive. He's just a beautiful person. So I'm truly blessed to be with him.
Amen.
Oh, we are truly blessed, Bishops, co-conveners, to share you, the couple, with us, to share your love of God with us. Yes. What a blessing. Let's give God the praise for the grace.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Thank
we
you,
have our
Kim.
Call to action.
Oh no, I'm going I'm coming back.
This is what we're all about. Thank you to the grace for completing that with the most celebratory way. Actually, it's not the most, but one of the closest, the appetizer, the call to action to celebrate. I know a great couple who knows a lot about that.
Yeah,
kiss.
I'm back now. The class, don't start it because I'll go back again.
I see. You look different. There's a little glow on the side of your face now.
Exactly.
There's a more shining glow on the side of your face that Max kissed. We are so blessed. We have another
Amen.
Couple who display the true love of God.
Amen.
And they do it with a kiss, meaning in that word, K-I-S-S, you know, we keep it simple, saints. Amen.
Yes.
We keep it simple. We're not with jargon theology. He's the one. His couple helps me realize what I realized long time ago, that I was blessed. And he keeps emphasizing it anytime we gather. Let us welcome the Allens, my great brother, but a true fatherly heart of God. A great mother, a great sister, but with a great motherly heart. Brother Bishop, my great Tyron and Valerie Allen. Let's hear from you.
God bless you. God bless you. I'm going to let my wife go first.
You're a wise man.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Okay. What I'm grateful for. I'm grateful for his commitment to our marriage through ups and downs. He's always been committed. And I'm grateful for four beautiful children that we had together and their families. I'm grateful for the balance that he provides in my life, because I can tend to be like a overthinker or a worrier sometimes, and he's intellectual. So we have that perfect balance, you know.
I like the balance. Yes, man, very important.
When I'm trying to go up, you know, he can help bring me down and talk things through, so that we balance each other out. So I'm grateful for that.
Hallelujah. That's grateful for balance. I can echo that. Thank you, Mommy. Thank you, Mother Valerie, a sister with a motherly heart. Go ahead, Bishop.
Amen.
It's on you now.
Call me intellectual. I've heard that before. I've been called a few things. Bless you, everyone. This is such a great time, that we have opportunity to reflect on the goodness of God this entire Thanksgiving season. I read a statistic that this past Thursday was the greatest day of consumption of food in the entire year. I know at our house that might have been true, even though this was very strange for us because we shared it just with each other. Normally we would have family and friends gather, but it gave us a chance to reflect a little more intimately each other. And that I am grateful, because as time goes on and more demands are put upon you, given the purpose that God has placed on your life, those moments of intimacy seem to dwane more and more and get away from us sometimes, and we don't have that time to reflect and to share. And we were able to, of course, do that this time. And this young lady in my life, for going on almost 50 years now.
Hallelujah.
50. Did you say 50 or 15?
Look like 14.
On our next anniversary. And
47. Yeah. And, amen.
It's been a wonderful ride, because she is so easy to love. And you can't take the Jesus out of the commitment. You can't take the Jesus out of the union. You can't take the Jesus out of the relationship. But when you have someone easy to love and you have Jesus, it just makes that dish so much more appetizing. Thanksgiving. it's just a wonder and a benefit to have someone so wonderful to share life's journey with.
Amen.
Time is short. I was listening to Dr. Patra, and she was talking about the longevity of her parents. And that, I think, is a blessing. I celebrate not only you, but your parents as well.
Huge blessing.
Yes. And as wonderful as that sounds, we still must realize that life is short.
Yes, it is.
And therefore, we should realize every day giving God thank you for the benefit that he daily loads us with. This is the scripture. And we can't get around that. If we look back and see what the Lord has done for me, I just have to shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory
was,
to God.
God was in it from the beginning, and he's still today. And certainly we take this time just to say thankful. Thankful also, and in my closing, to all of my friends. This opportunity through Heavenly Couples, I think, is monumentous. It's just a wonderful opportunity to see couples working together in ministry.
Wow.
I think this is not only a great thing today, but God said it. It was not good that man should be alone. He's doing well, but I want to bless him special. And that special blessing was to give him a mate. And the two of them then journeyed through life together.
Yeah.
And good times, bad times. That's part of the journey. But when we look back and see all that he's brought us through, we should be able to say that our good times outweigh our bad times.
Yes.
And we won't complain.
Hallelujah.
God bless you.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Our good times outweigh our bad times.
Yes.
That is the truth. And the Jesus in me, which is the Holy Spirit presence in me, recognizes the Jesus in all of you. The Holy Spirit presence in all of us. Thank you, Bishop Allen. You will be hearing more from the Allens next Saturday as we would be having our first True Love Symposium. The evidence that God is with us is how we walk together, not just as husband and wives, but as friends, the body of Christ, more couples coming together, not just as couples, but as men and women. So we have some single persons with us who are going to, they are blessed because God is in each one's life. Thank you to the Allens again for encouraging us.
Amen.
Allens are one of our founding conveners, and we have another founding convener today. They have been very instrumental. As I introduce everyone, you know, it's with gratitude, and we do this all the time, just with gratitude, celebrating. And so this other couple that will come, they need no introduction to anybody here. Brother Yuji is truly a brother with a fatherly heart. Mrs. Michiko Yokoyama, truly a sister with a motherly heart. And so without further ado, this great couple representing the son and daughter of God in one as husband and wife. Let us welcome the Yokoyamas as they give thanks for each other.
Well, of course, I'm grateful for being alive at this time, and under God's protection, Christ's protection, and who remembers, you know, every hair in my head and everything. I'm eternally grateful for that. And of course, I'm also grateful for my better half, my wife, who also is like a sister sometime, mother sometime, and daughter sometime. And we have been in marriage for 45 years. 45 years working together and, continuing. So if we continue working like Energizer Bunny, for 45 years, what distance shall we cover? It will go around the earth many, many times. So, we have really come in long journey together, in the hill, valley, and the mountains, all sharing together. So every moment over this past 45 years, I truly appreciate and grateful for God who has given me such a faithful, unchanging faithful, spouse.
Unchanging faithful spouse. I like that.
And also, I'm also very grateful for the beautiful nature which surrounds us. And, you know, regardless of COVID-19 or tempest or a storm, whatever happens, then there's always a beautiful sunlight and nature surrounding us, enriching our life. And, you know, being very grateful for that.
Amen. 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 Thank you, brother. Thank you, brother, with a fatherly heart, for your better half. Now, better half, share why he calls you the better half. I'm sure there's something great about Yuji-san that we don't know. Tell us.
Yeah, thank you so much, everyone. Yeah, I am eternally grateful to my husband. His commitment to God and Jesus, and commitment for our marriage. So, from us, we have four children and four grandchildren. So we are really grateful to my family. And despite of this pandemic, we are protected and we are safe and healthy. So I am very grateful. And also I am grateful to Father Bayo, who organizes this ministry to fellowship each other and encourage each other and to promote our values, family values, because so many couples are breaking down and the family value is breaking down. And we really have to go to heaven with a family, not a single person. So family is really basis of the heavenly kingdom. So we really promote this true family value. Thank you so much.
God for you. Thank God for you. You are very, your couple, as every other couple here as a convener, so instrumental in hearing God's voice on that wonderful conference call we had. And we are here together, thanking God for each one. Thank you, Michiko-san and Yuji, for your true parental love, the Christ consciousness. Another great lady with us. I don't know if her if my brother is with her, but we want to hear at this time from Barbara, Dr. Barbara. I've been knowing Barbara for a while, and I'm just so glad that we can reconnect more artistically with the Heavenly Couples in Ministry. Barbara, tell us why you love Heavenly Couples, and tell us something about that great man. I know him as Carlton, Carl Bishop Carlton Rainey, brother with a true fatherly heart. Why are you grateful today?
Amen. Yes, you know, I'm just so glad to be here on this morning to join in on this call. Thank you so much, Father Bayo, for what you're doing and for your work. Dr. Patra, for such a beautiful, beautiful prayer. You know, and all everyone who has shared, you know, over the Thanksgiving holiday, it gave a chance to really come get in touch with some real thankfulness. You know, it was a different holiday in that, you know, we were in, you know, our family consists of four children. We have 18 grandchildren and six great grands. So, you know, that becomes a big unit, you know, when you really come together. And what we usually do anyhow is just kind of go from house to house, because it's very difficult to get everyone into the same space. But, you know, even with all of this, you know, we had a chance to really share in still, you know, in increments. And the family unit was such that, you know, we almost didn't even realize we were being somewhat semi-quarantined, because there was so much fellowship that was still going on and so much love that was still going on. Bishop was so excited over the holiday. He just wanted to share with the children, you know, your mother, she says, she just loves me so much. Look how she just loves me. And he just continues, really, to be the biggest baby in the household. You know, we are so grateful for that. You know, and I watch, you know, the kids, they're already preparing and planning for what they want to do for him for Christmas. They are always trying to do something very, very special for him and really remember him and the love that he has given to us over the years. You know, he's not the same person that he has been. And, you know, as time goes on, we learn to really appreciate him really for where he is and where he has been and the total person really that's around us all the time. And we're just so very, very grateful for everything that has come through, you know. I always, this time of year, I always get a chance to say I'm grateful for one other thing. You know, when as Sarah was had passed, Abraham only wanted one thing, to find a good wife for his son. And I always get back to this. I'm grateful for my sons, and I'm grateful that God has given them wonderful wives, really, that they could share in the faith and we could just all continue as a family and keep this thing going. So it's a time of great, great gratitude. And I'm so thankful just to be here with all my friends here also. And thank you for having the couples.
Thank Amen. You. Thank you for wow. you. Thank you. Thank you for you.
Thank you. Barbara. Thank you. Thank you so much, Bishop Barbara, for the breakfast too. Yes. Oh. It's good to come to your house and have breakfast.
Yes. The counter is so ready. Much. Already looks like breakfast has been served.
It's ready. We're coming. We're coming.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you. We have several other persons who are going to share within this time limit. One of our earliest connection with the globe, in light of we are here in the United States, we were able to connect earlier on with a great ministry in India, and our brother is with us. He's also part of the Heavenly Couples. He has a great vision from God for us to establish a Heavenly Couples University teaching center in India. And so we want to hear from Param Jyoti. What are you grateful for today? Where's your wife? I don't see your wife with you, but let us hear. We want to hear from you. What are you grateful for? How are you grateful for your wife and what God is doing? Speak to us, sir.
Welcome. Yes, yes, yes. Come on. Yes, my wife is coming. Yes. So
continue speaking. She will join you. Go ahead.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you for this, the opportunity to giving. So this is my angel. We have 10 years since we got married, 10 years. Now the 10 years ago. So our marriage, it has been 10 years. Now it's, so 11 years, we overcome to the 11 years. So, and I can say that this is my wife and angel in my life. So God has given. So I am belongs to state of Andhra Pradesh. It is another state. My wife is belongs to another state. So West Bengal, Calcutta. I think you heard the name of the Calcutta.
Yes.
Calcutta. So God made us. And I believe that this is the plan of God. And God chooses. We are a blessed couple in the ministry of God. So God chooses. We alone, we came to this Kakinada, the place of Kakinada. We both are, we alone to come here and no one there. So we could overcome all the persecutions and troubles, a lot of things. So we had been a lot of problems. We overcome by the prayer. We kneel down at the feet of God. And we continue to pray. I can say that my wife is at all the time. She is so wonderful and so support me. So in the time of beginning, while we came to Kakinada, we had nothing. I mean, we had no food. We had nothing. We can say that a long time along years that we had been seeking in the presence of the Lord, and we don't we had know the house also, even the house, so that my wife has supported me in the prayer, in my ministry, and I can say that I am blessed by this heavenly couple in ministry, because I joined, it is a plan of God with you, sir, and everybody, all of you, the heavenly couples. Really, I am enjoying it, and I'm sharing my small testimony because of, I blessed by your supporting. Thank you so much.
We thank God for you. Remind us your wife's name. What's your wife's name again?
Phoebe.
Thank you, Phoebe. Thank you so much for your wonderful love. Loving my brother with a fatherly heart, loving him with a motherly heart as a great
bless
daughter
you,
of God.
Bless you, my sister. Bless you.
Yes.
Thank you. Oh my God. Let us go across the border now. Our neighbor in Pakistan, Bishop Vargas, our new co-convener in Pakistan, doing great work. Unmute yourself so that we can hear from you and your wonderful wife, Sabado. And also he has with him today, Simon Marsh, his interpreter. Let us welcome the Vargas, the One in Christ Ministry. Bishop Vargas, give us your Thanksgiving testimony. You had a letter you want to read. Can you share now? Unmute. Release.
And the interpreter too, on mute.
Not yet. Both of you on mute.
Okay. Are you listening to me?
Yes, we can hear you now. Read your Thanksgiving letter for us, if you want to. Go ahead, sir.
Yeah. Everybody, good morning from Pakistan. I love you also. And I'm very happy. We are also very happy to join the Heavenly Couple Ministries. So today, 3 points. How are we thankful? How we thank Lord for the blessings. Second, how much we are grateful. Third, why we are thankful and grateful. Number one, by opening our hearts for Lord, devoting our heart and life as thanksgiving to the Lord, as will wish to be more and more thankful to him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Second, the love and blessings of God unto our lives are uncountable and infinite. There is no limit how much you can be grateful and thankful to Lord, as he does not define and count how much and how many blessings does he give to us or already gives to us. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, yes.
Number third, we are thankful to him. We must thankful and grateful to him as loving and obedient children, as a true and loving heavenly fathers love us. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
All of you. May all always with you, and I'm very happy. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We are very happy for you. Thank you, Bishop Vargas.
More my interpreter talk with all you.
Okay. Brother Simeon, share your Thanksgiving gratitude. Thank you, Bishop Vargas and Mother Sabado Vargas. Thank you.
Blessings in the name of the Lord Jesus to all my brothers and sisters in Christ. Hope you are doing well. So today, I'm very thankful to the Heavenly Couple Ministries, and especially Father Bio, that he took us into the Zoom meeting so that we may present our ideology and ideas according to the word of God. And therefore, I understand that thanksgiving is not just a word that we present or speak unto the Lord. It is a behavior of love. It is a behavior of submission, a behavior of obedience unto the Lord. Because most of the people understand that only just say thanks, O Lord, for all your blessings is enough to thanks the Lord. But I think that it does not. Because when we just spoke from our lips, then we cannot be grateful and thankful in the circumstances of our temptation. In a worse circumstances, then sure, the devil can lead us very far away from the Lord. And especially as I'm thankful to Bishop Dr. Amin Mukas, serving at One in Christ State Farm in Pakistan. And therefore, I have a great wish into my heart so that I may do some great and good to all my brothers and sisters in Christ and with them, so that the name of the Jesus may glorify. And all this I have in my heart as I'm young and unmarried. So I think that Lord is enough for me. The love of my Lord is enough for me.
Amen.
And I'm very thankful to all my brothers and sisters in Christ to hear me. And I think when we will do it together by, we can do it very more and effectively, because the word of God unites us on every moment and on every step of our lives. As Brother Bio, Father Bio, preached in the last Sunday, that we have to be united if we want to run a race and we really want to win, then we have to walk together by with our brother and sisters. And the most of the people got blessed, and everyone there appreciated the sermon of the Father Bio, and they was very happy. And when I translated the sermon, they was shouting with joy. They was praising hallelujah. And the Father Bio was very happy seeing the people praising the Lord, saying hallelujah. And this moment was very special. And I think that that moment really gave me inner peace and comfort and blessing and a very joy. And I hope that Father Bai also enjoyed the situation, enjoyed the environment and the prayer that was held previous Sunday. I hope you enjoyed, Father Bai.
I did, Simon.
God be with you and God bless you all.
Bless you. Let your love to Simon. A rock. Simon Peter is a rock. And Simon, yes. You know something? You just shared something that all of us here are going to, we are called to make sure everybody find their better half. And so you are going to be married not only to God. The only way you can be married to God is God is going to give you a great God's daughter coming to you. And so Amen. Prepare yourself. Amen. Amen. Thank you for your testimony.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. We have online also, thank you to our brothers and sisters in Pakistan, in India. As we continue to expand God's love, we have to do it again together. We are not a place here of trying to figure out the theology of God. We already know the theology of God. We already know how to talk about God, but we are here to embody, to demonstrate how God seeks us to build the kingdom here together. So thank you for echoing those great true thoughts that are directly from the throne of heaven. We have with us two brothers, a sister and a brother again, who would like to share. Elder Juliet, unmute yourself, sister. Elder Juliet? Elder Juliet? Potter? If you can, when you can, unmute yourself. We would like to welcome you and hear from you. Elder Juliet is truly a woman of God, and we are grateful for her participation today. We also have with us online all the way from England, Reverend Minister Babatunde Oluwude. Can you unmute yourself, sir? Here we go. Wow, finally. Amen. Amen. Oluwude will let you know. Are you married yet, sir, or not yet?
Yes, I'm married, sir.
Ah, you qualify.
It's in the college. College of married people.
It's in the college of the married. So today, what are you grateful for, Babatunde Oluwude? What are you really grateful for about that wonderful woman God gave you? You didn't make her. God gave you and you discovered her. Why are you grateful today, sir?
I thank God that she's a blessing to the family, to myself, and she's a pointer that God is using to direct and to regulate in our own little ways. Yeah, God has been faithful. Yeah.
I love the word you use, regulate. Continue.
And to help us to, you know, men can see, but not very critically. But women can see better than men can see. They have extra eyes.
I can go. Even...
Yeah, and also, I think they are closer to God than men in a way. Because they are the first one that saw Jesus Christ. When Jesus...
Make it plain for us.
So, yeah, it's a blessing that I cannot quantify. God is good. Thank God.
Amen. Brother Oluwude. We are grateful for you. Just again, those few words for the wise, it's something we cannot sometimes qualify and quantify. God's blessings are so abundant, they overflow, but they start from our homes with thanksgiving. So we thank you,
Father Bayo.
Yes.
Sorry to disturb you. You have a special number or a special thing, Elder Juliet is on the phone. And she's on mute. So how can she take herself off of mute while she's using her phone? Is there a special?
Is that what it is?
Yes.
*6.
*6? Or can you take her off of mute on your end? Can you take her off of mute on your end?
Let me do that. I ask her to unmute. I can only ask because she's on the
phone.
When
you ask, she will see the sign.
Okay,
and
I've
then
done
she
that.
Will click on that.
So have a hit.
Yeah,
six.
She got it now.
Okay.
Yeah, she's off now. Okay, Elder Juliet.
Oh. How are you?
Hey, we hear you.
Thank you.
Welcome, my dear sister.
Hi, Elder.
Hi, how are you? Reverend Sinclair, it's nice to see you. We talk very often.
Oh, yes.
Can you also
the stage is yours.
You also see me?
No, no one can see you.
We can only.
You're not on video. If you're
on
video,
video.
We'll see.
Let me see if I can.
There's a video sign there. You can press on the video sign.
Okay. I guess you're very good at the computerized, but that's okay. I'm learning.
We all are.
There's a sign there that says video. Just press on it.
I don't see the video sign, but that's okay.
Okay.
So just share with us. I know you would be joining us more often as we get this to go, but we are so grateful to have you with us. As was shared earlier, Reverend Dr. Sinclair Gray introduced Elder Juliet Porter Mitchell to us. She has a lot of the First Nations, our great brothers and sisters, the First Nations. Unfortunately, we call them India, but you know, the reason we call them India is because Columbus made a mistake in thinking he was going, they were trying to get to India, really. And these are the things we have to correct in our history. And because the truth be told, what we hear about the pilgrims is not all that so correct.
That's right.
What we hear about the good old days, if they were that good, we should be in better days. But those days were not so good. And that's why we are where we are. And so I'm so grateful for Elder Porter. I pray she can share a heart of gratitude. We do not do this because America say we should give thanks. I want you to be very clear. Everybody on this line and anybody who will listen to this in the future, we are here because we know for a fact we have to be grateful.
Amen.
We have to be grateful, not because I say it, but because it is the way of God. It is the way of true love. It is the only way for us to truly represent God. As I will read one scripture and then I will open up so that others, I will see Sister Potter can share and my wife can share. When we look at the book of Thessalonians, 1 Thessalonians, I believe, it is very clear, 1 Thessalonians 5 and the other scriptures that can validate. It says from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, we look at verse 16. You should read the whole book. If I had time, we would read all of it. It says from 16, I should what? I should rejoice always. Always be joyful.
Yeah.
And never stop praying.
Yes.
Whatever happens, somebody read that for me. Keep
thanking God because
he said whatever.
Keep thanking God.
God. And go back to 18.
Whatever happens.
Keep thanking God.
Whatever happens.
Whatever.
Keep thanking God because of Jesus Christ. This is what God wants you to do.
Very simple.
Yeah.
Very simple. Very simple. We don't need no, excuse the phrase, Bishop Allen and others, great bishops, excuse the phrase, jargon theology. We don't need no more jargon theology to understand we got to give God thanks. Whether I am down, whether I don't feel like it, I've got to give God thanks because God loves me. God loves the world. And this is why we give thanks. So, Sister Porter, share with us anything on your heart about Thanksgiving today.
Thank you. First, let me thank you for letting me join. I am a widow. So
you qualify your widows because in spirit, when you read, I want that again, sorry, a coachable moment for us. The reason people like you are here with us because we know eternally our spouses, even though widowers, you are still one. Amen. Go ahead, sister.
My husband passed. We only had a decade to be together. But you know, along the way, there was always someone who came along and helped me with the grieving process. And in that, I learned two words that I try to remember regularly: comfort and compassion. They're two words that people do not understand how to give comfort. They do not understand sometimes how to give, how to be compassionate. So as I journeyed and became an elder, it became something that I had learned, but I had to make sure that I did not forget. You hear quite, when you become an elder, you hear and you experience trauma from the lives of people who have not had good journeys, who have not had good lives. I'm not the judge. God is the judge. My job is to listen and try to help them remember that they are still loved by God. I don't. Know what else to say. That's, I have.
She's muted.
Like you muted yourself. And Sister Juliet, you mistakenly hit your mute button. But we did hear, go ahead. You can finish up now. Go ahead.
Okay. I am grateful for the people who have come into my life. You know, people come into your life for a very short time, but they're there because they're there for you, to keep you on that journey towards your purpose. Mm. So I have met some really wonderful people in my life for a very short period. They were there with lessons and they were there with messages. This is who you are, Juliet. This is where you need to go. Stay on the path to where you're supposed to go towards your purpose. It has been interesting. There have been some bumps, and I've had to pick myself up and keep going. But along the way, I was very grateful for the bumps because it helped me appreciate the brightness, the light, the sunshine. You know, when you're in a storm, you don't always think that you'll come out of it, but you got to do a lot of praying, a lot of praying. And remember that you, God still loves you. He's giving you this because he wants you to understand. Pray. You have to pray to him to get out of the storm. Okay. I think I've said, and I really appreciate the time that you've given me to be a part of this Zoom. I'm going to tell you, this is my first Zoom. So I'm
Look
nervous.
At that. Look at that. Look at that. This is a breakthrough for all of us to go have right. you first. Go ahead.
No. Go ahead, sir. Go ahead. No,
we just want to thank you again. You facilitated newness into us by sharing that this is your first time to Zoom as a result of HCIM, as a result of our connection with God, with you, through you, through Dr. all of us. So we look forward to see you, hear from you. You are a part of us now, and we are grateful for you, Elder Julia Potter. Let us show love for our great sister, giving thanks to us for comfort and compassion. Very, very moving clarity why we should be grateful. Before we end, I thought we would want to hear from one special person in my life. She is beyond special. I don't find the right adjectives, the right qualification. I just know one thing that, you know, as was said, all things works together for good. And
hallelujah.
God gave me something that really is working together for more than good, if there's anything more than good. And so I am just grateful. I don't know how to say this to my spouse, my wife, only to say truly I've realized, realized why she's with me. She's given birth to prayerfully a true man of God. I look at her as my second Messiah, and that should not make anybody shrink or feel somehow. You know, when a military comes into a place where people are suffering, and when they liberate the people really thank them like God. They thank them as messiahs, as liberators. They come as saviors. Amen? You should understand very clear. They come as saviors. And so the word messiah should not be something that divides us, but it's something that God wants us to put into our lifestyle. We, without people like you, people like Brother Jyoti in Pakistan, I mean in India where he is, there will be young orphans and people who will never feel God's love, never know God's love. So we are all as disciples of Christ in a messianic mission, all of us. Because the only way people will see Jesus, see God, it is through us loving. And loving is not, I say I love you, as Bishop Allen will remind us. If I come to you, say I'm hungry, and you say you love me, and you say, well, I pray for you, then you don't love me. And you still have a small loaf of bread that you're saving for only you yourself and your family in the fridge. And you say, you pray for me. No, you do like what the widow did for Elijah. Gave everything she had to the man of God. And guess what? She was more blessed. Her cupboard never ran out of flour. Mm-hmm. So what are we saying? We have messianic people. The true family values. It's about first cherishing God in the family. Because love begins where? At home. Charity begins where? At home. So where should gratitude begin? Where should thanksgiving begin?
At home.
It should begin at home. And it should begin because in my home, the Messiah is present. God's Spirit is present. And it is ever more present in my wife. In my wife. As has been said, we must know the truth. No man gives birth women. So God must, in a way, he gave birth to the world. God must have something. Why we call our women the better half. So there must be something about that. So Mrs. Bayo, I love you. I don't need to say it. I pray my actions demonstrate it. I pray that you realize that you are more than the apple of my eye. You are the one who makes me still stay in America. You're the one who make me do whatever I do. I do it because you are regulating, as Brother Olu would say, whether I like it or not, you are regulating the spirit. Because I can get so compassionate, I can get so passionate, but she knows how to say, hey, you know, tapa it down, Father Bayo. So Mrs. Bayo, Mrs. Ayano, Ishi, Adrian, Bayo, I love you. Thank you for everything. Thank you for everything. Unmute yourself.
Thank you, Father Bayo. It's always nice to receive the love from husband and to know that husband was happy and be grateful with my existence here. What can I say, how I am grateful to my husband? First of all, the most foremost grateful to the Heavenly Parent. At the same time, I cannot leave my husband out of the Heavenly Parent will in my life. That point, I am forever grateful to my husband. Without his faith and dedication to God, I may be able to live the life truly in God completely. To the point, be so grateful to live in God. I'm sorry.
Aww.
He's such a blessing. At that point, I'm so grateful to my husband. I often call myself a living in warm water. As you know, in Japan, a blessed country, we have many things to live, just to enjoy ourselves. Nothing to be lack in such a lifestyle. You know, I came to America as missionary to help God work. Was completely different experience in spite of my response to his calling. What that mean, like, truly able to, through life with him, able to came to the point to be grateful for definitely the scripture he put today about the spiritual rebirth. Sorry, I didn't remember the word. The spirit of cleansing the spirit. I could see God's hand through his presence. God chose my husband to be my partner. I'm able to came to the point with my soul truly resonance to be excited for my true future to serve everyone. He's very selfless man. He's very selfless man. He don't look after him, of course. So advice sometimes becoming burden because have to, you know, make sure he's okay. Also, the surrounding him is okay. Becoming as I knew the reality in God's sight became so great to who he is. So thank you.
Amen. Amen, Mrs. So Bayo. Any more? Save some for next year.
Yeah.
I love you. Let's show love to Mrs. Bayo.
Oh my God. She is so loving. She can't even, you know, she can't even, oh God.
I know grace, you, Mother Bayo. Our gratitude so overflows. And that's for every one of you, every one of us online. I think we've really been equipped by gratitude today.
Yes.
Let gratitude continue to flow from each one. Tomorrow you have another blessed opportunity. You will meet with your circle of influence, meaning your church members, your organization members. You would receive message from Dr. Gray, who is like, he spits out God's word lovingly.
Yes. Thank you so much, Dr. Gray. Yes,
we're so grateful.
Thank you.
Every one of you, know that you have another opportunity tomorrow to give thanks. Celebrate your membership. Let me just put this. One thing sometimes we don't do enough in institutionalized Christian communities, we call churches, is we do not celebrate the members enough. We look to celebrate the pastor. Oh, pastor's there, and it's good. It's okay, nothing wrong with that. But whose responsibility then is it to celebrate the members? It is you, the pastor, you, the parent figure, you who know better about gratitude. And so let it not just be because, quote unquote, America decided once a year to eat all the turkey in the world on Thursday. Let it not be because of that you inherit. But if that would help us inherit a life of gratitude, let it flow every Sunday, every time you gather in your meetings. Let gratitude flow. Let it start with gratitude while you're grateful. And with this, no doubt you invite God. God becomes fully present, knowing that it is not a complaint party. It's not a misery party. It's a place where we are celebrating God, because God cannot be kept down. Nothing can stop God's love. Nothing can keep us away. Nothing. I say nothing. And so let us continue. I'm so blessed to be with you, to be in ministry with all of you. Let us continue to celebrate each other. Please celebrate your membership. Most important, and watch what happens. Without you saying anything, you begin to be blessed in such a way. So I want to just share one more thing. Next Saturday, we're going to have our True Love Symposium. And as all of you know, we host a meeting on Monday. And so we want to encourage you to join us. Those of you who can join us, especially the co-conveners, you will get a Zoom link for the meeting on Monday. We are going to correct this heavily. Forgive my spelling. It happens, but you know what we're talking about. So our International Family True Love Symposium, we choose to love with gratitude in resemblance to God, our Creator. It's a family affair. It's a worldwide affair. So share this flyer with everyone from today. It's going to be sent out to you today. Once you get it, share it with your congregation. We thank God for Dr. Gray, Dr. Rollet, their contributions. We look up, we see people contributing. Every money that is contributed to ACIM, we are going to use it to further the work of ACIM overseas, not just here in America. So whatever you feel you can give, feel free to give. I will put a Cash App button, IFC, RVA. We want to dedicate this, our Thanksgiving season, to our brothers and sisters' missions that are overseas. So Please share widely and encourage whoever and whosoever to be part of our True Love Symposium. Amen. Dr. Rolay, do you have anything to add to that announcement? And Dr. Gray, those of you who have been to the meetings?
Well, are we still meeting on Monday?
Yes, we're meeting on Monday, but if you have anything to add to the announcement to encourage others. Yes, we meet Monday 8 p.m. just to finalize the program with you, yes. Co-conveners.
I'm good then.
Huh?
I think we're good.
Okay. Dr. Gray, anything?
I think it's good. I would definitely, you and I talked yesterday, Father, but I would just remind everybody, as you share this information, the Zoom information that you have for the meetings, for the Saturday meetings, will be the same Zoom information for next Saturday. That's one of the things I was concerned about. Are you creating a different Zoom? And Father Bio said, no, it'll be the same Zoom. So if you share it with your congregation, share it with your outside outside friends and family, please make sure you share the Zoom information.
Amen. So you would get the same Zoom link you used to join today with a password. It will be attached to the flyer. And some of you have already seen the promo. We are going to get better and better because God is in this. Our promos will get better. Everything we do will get better. As you notice that you are a co-owner. This is not Father Bio and Mrs. Bio's thing. It is our thing as couples, yes. Heavenly couples. So join us, give input, and your input is valued. Very much valued, and we would continue to let the Holy Spirit guide.
Father Bayo,
yes, ma'am.
I would like to thank everyone who was linking up with the happy birthday thing. I really want to tell you how much I appreciate that. I mean, it's so huge, even though I try to celebrate my birthday the whole month. But when that thread keep coming in, I feel like I have a family.
Oh,
so really, thank you. And Dr. St. Clair, thank you for the prayers and encouraging letters. I call it letters. It's no longer email, because emails come in, I ignore tells us of them. But I have to open up yours. So that's letters. Thank you so much. And to all the family of Heavenly Couples, I want to let you know how much I appreciate all of you. Dr. Renee, all the international persons we have. I love you from the Rolays. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Bishop Rolay. Thank you. You are truly a daughter of God, a sister with a motherly, true motherly heart. Anyone else? Any pressing thoughts? I know it's always like Thanksgiving, when we gather as a family, it's always difficult to say goodbye. I don't know if that happens to you. It always happens to me. yesterday, we entertained our godchildren and they came. They've not been by for a while. And guess what? After 3-4 hours, there was time to leave. We said, they didn't want to go. they were begging the parents, let's stay, let's see. Oh, God.
Start living here.
Yeah. So they were crying. I mean, literally, that was quite an experience. And many times, I cannot wait till Saturday to see you guys.
I think Elder Juliet finally Elder found Juliet! Something. She finally found her way.
Look at God. There's a reason we had to stay longer. Because we wanted to see the face of that shining light of God.
Yes. I'm nervous at the bottom of the screen.
Yes. Now you know. Now you know, right?
I'm getting there.
Yes, let's just have to figure this thing out. This is the new norm.
Yes.
You know, Father Bio,
yes.
There is never a goodbye. It is only until next time.
There you go. There you go. This is because the beauty of HCIM. There's never a goodbye. It's only till next time.
Yeah.
So on that wonderful note, as Max Rolay always knows how to keep it short and beautiful, never a goodbye, but until next time, brothers and sisters, be excited. Share the link even again. Be encouraged.
Yes.
Show that you really love what God is doing. Share the link far and wide. And we're not looking for just numbers. We're looking for quality. We're looking to really help people know that one with God is a majority.
Amen.
And many are called. Unfortunately, few are chosen for such a work. Barbara, thank you. Say hello to Carlton. Give him a kiss. Mrs. Bayo, come closer for our action. It's action time. It's call to action. Sorry, Roles. It's call to action.
You want me to go action now?
It's call to action.
Can I call action?
It's call to action. Vargas, it's call to action. Show me something, Vargas.
Okay. Okay. You're asking for it. Don't worry.
Once we do that, we do it for everybody. And
all right.
God is kissing you more than I kiss you. The sunshine is out there. If you are in a place where you can go out, take a walk. Don't zoom in and get like Buddha. you can go out, take a walk, and enjoy God's love through the sunshine, the wind, and know that Amen. We are living in God. We are already in heaven. So Amen. Thank you. Babatunde from England, please join us anytime. With your spouse and anyone, share the link far and wide. Babatunde, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
All right. Dr. Gray, who's gonna bless us with a blessing prayer? Somebody got to say a grace. Bishop Vargas, you're the bishop, I guess. Bishop Vargas, say short prayer, short prayer. Give us blessing, give us grace, yes.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Jesus. Let's pray. Kadus, 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 Rabbal Fash, Asman, or Zameen.
O Lord God Almighty, who was and is and is to come.
Aaj, Khudam Tere, Banna, Fandar, Banko, Sibisis, or Sari, Bibo,
Lord, my God, I hand over Father Byron and his missus and all our brothers and sisters who joined us.
I
my Lord, I especially pray for the blessing and for the encouragement for the heavenly couple and mysteries.
Ekadam kadam, apne hum ko, apne mission ko, apne bachon ko. Manen ka is ki saar, in ko, mission ko tere haath ko
mere. Lord, my God, I hand over myself, my missus, and my children, and all my church team and church people under your hand.
और खुदा मैं से मिन्नत करता हूं कि इतने प्यारे इन लोगों के सामने बुलाया है ये इलाही रिफाकत है मोहब्बत
एंड आई एम ग्रेटफुल टू यू दैट यू हैव ब्लेस्ड अस विद दिस लव्ड पीपल हु टॉक अस योर होली वर्ड एंड योर ग्रेट लव
दामन पूरी दुनिया तमाम मुल्कों के लिए इनके गाइडेंस के लिए सारी आल दुनिया की कलीसियाओं के लिए बरकत और सलामती की दुआ मांगता
हूं। Our Lord, I pray for all the countries and for all the presidents and all the government establishments of the countries. Take over them so that they may be in peace. And bless them with
everlasting
peace.
Yes, Lord.
And I pray unto you to bless us so that heavenly couples in ministry and one in Christ ministry may work together by us so that we may win many souls for you, O my Lord. And I ask for your mercy and for your love and all the resources to give us so that we may preach your name as well. We may feed the hungry, we may help the poor and the widows and the orphans in your holy name by you.
और खुदावन तेरा खादम होते हुए कोरोना वायरस की नाम को तेरे यीशु नाम में जाहिर करने का हुक्म देता हूँ उस इख्तियार के साथ जो तुमने आसमान से दिया हुआ है.
And in thy holy name, I pray and I diminish and eliminate the all effect of coronavirus because you have given your men the authority from the heavens.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Or in Christ or heavenly conformity ko tere paak lahu mein swata hu tere paak Christo ki afazat mein dikha hu ki is par tera khaas khususi shakat wala paak.
Oh my Lord, again me and my family and Father Bio and his family and heavenly couples in ministry, I cover them with your holy blood and hide them beside your holy blood.
Ye sab kuch tere bete apne khudaan Yesu Masih ke naam se maang leta hoon.
I ask all these things in the holy name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Unmute, unmute yourself. Unmute. God the praise. Unmute. No silent praise. Unmute.
Thank you, Lord.
Give God the glory. Give God the praise. All praises belong to our God.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes. Thank you, Bishop. Let's have a great Amen. Sunday. Have a great Saturday. Continue to share heavenly love with everyone you see. Love you. Talk to you soon.
Love you.
Love you, Simon. Simon, you're going to find God wants to give you good woman, Simon.